Hi friends, my name is Lisette Ruiz and I am a blogger and YouTuber here at my crafty space, and I'm going to show you today how to create stickers in Silhouette Studio. Sticker shops right now are super popular and I love it. I'm actually thinking about doing one myself, and I know that some people desperately want to know how to do this. So I'm gonna try to do it in less than 5 minutes for you. So this is a sticker that I think is super cute, mom hair, don't care. And I'm gonna show you how I do it from scratch. So step one is to set up your page. So you're gonna go into Silhouette Studio, click the Page Setup tab. Your design area is going to be your typical Cameo mat. That's what I have. If you have a portrait, it's obviously gonna be the portrait mat. Your media size is going to be letter size. So that's what you're going to select there. Then, when I am cutting things out, I like to show my grid. In this case, I'm not going to show my grid because I know exactly where my print area is going to be. Then, you want to click the next tab that says registration marks. You want to turn your registration marks on. I have the Silhouette Cameo 4, which lends itself to being finicky with finding registration marks, so I do not minimize the size of my registration marks. You can try with your machine. There are so many different workarounds. Sorry for any background noise, I have kids. What I always do is just go ahead and restore defaults, make sure that the registration marks are nice and big so that my machine will find them. So that's what I do first. Then I go over to the text box. I type in the first part, mom hair. Then I go ahead and select another text box, text feature, don't care. So since I kind of know how I want it to look, I already have two fonts that I want to choose. I go over here to the font section. You select the font, the text box that you want to customize. You can see here I have tons of different fonts downloaded. That's a video for another day on how to import those. But I am going to go ahead and pick the Bebas font, which is one that I really like to use for the mom hair. And you can already see it set up over here on this side. The don't care, I'm going to go ahead and choose the Novala font. That's what I like to use for that one. And again, it's already. You can see what it looks like over on the left. And let's just get there. There it is. Okay. So what I do is I go ahead and select everything because I like to see what it's going to look like. I like to set up the print and cut colors right away. So I make all of that black. I like to make the line style transparent. And the line color transparent. So then you're just going to kind of position things how you want them to be positioned. And I just go ahead right off the bat, I make this a compound pass. That is so that the machine or so that the software recognizes it as one shape. I make this a compound path. Rather than text, it's going to recognize it as one shape when we get to the next step now. So let's say I want my sticker to look something like this, which is kind of similar to what I created over there on the left. The next thing you're going to do is make this a compound path because that's it, basically. Our sticker is designed. This is the shape I want it to have. To get that white border around the sticker, you're going to do an offset. So, you are going to open the offset panel, click offset, and what I like to do is I make an offset big enough to surround the entire shape, and then I go ahead and edit from there. So, you just continue clicking up, or you can also drag the slider. So I'm going to continue dragging the slider until it covers the entire sticker. So then what I do from there is go ahead and click apply. I'm sure that there's a measurement that you could. So again, I'm sure that there is some, default size that you could do for this offset, but since I am not used to making stickers all the time, I am just going to do it the way I like to do it. So then I go ahead and I kind of go in a little bit after the offset is created, kind of the way I want it to be, and I just make the space the way I want, kind of, the padding around the sticker. So I just adjust it a little bit. If you don't like a lot of edge around your sticker, you don't have to do it this way. You can just you can put a little bit, you can put a lot, you can kind of adjust it the way you want. So the next thing I do after that is I make this line black just for personal preference. So you go back to your line color. Now there's a couple things you could do. If you don't mind that it prints a black line when you do print and cut, you can leave it black or you can make it transparent. It will still be there. So if you make it transparent, it will not show when you print and cut it. I know that there are some people that don't like it to be visible. Some people don't mind. So that's both options. So we basically just left it transparent, and I'm going to group this because I want the option to cut the edge of this. So if you go over to your send panel, you're going to see if you select cut, it's going to cut every shape in the shape. If you select cut edge, guess what? Now you're just cutting the edge of the sticker. So let's go back to design. We are going to select the sticker. We're going to go to the replicate panel and I'm going to select fill page. So it basically filled up my page this way. You can mess with it and you can duplicate and move things around however you'd like, depending on different settings, how many you can squeeze onto one page. So I was trying to see if it would squeeze two columns in there, but it didn't just because of the size of the sticker. But I'm going to show you with the smaller sticker how it looks when you select fill page. So here, fill page, you see it automatically turned it sideways and squeezed nine stickers on there. So now when I go to my send panel, cut edge is already selected, so I know that that's going to come out how I want it to. You're just going to go ahead and print. You're going to print on your sticker paper at the quality that you need to. Then you are going to cut. I'll leave that for another video because this was really just how to design the video, how to design the stickers on Silhouette Studio. So I hope that was helpful. And if you have any questions, drop it in the comments below. And I will make more of these if you like it. So enjoy!